So there's a lot of big things coming up in boxing. Fury or Joshua, who do you like?
Kind of go with Fury.
I got Joshua. Why Fury?
Because she's so unpredictable, man.
That's the guy who fought Wilder, right?
Yes.
Oh, God. He's so unpredictable.
He's big.
He's unpredictable, man. And he's very athletic for a big man.
Okay, Chris Arreola, Andy Ruiz. 50-50?
Yeah.
Okay, Lipinets, who you train, you know him very well, against Jerron Ennis. Jerron is 25-0, 23 knockouts.
Honestly, I would love to see Sergey win, but I got to go with Ennis.
It's a tough fight.
I think Ennis is going to be the next superstar.
Did you happen to see Virgil Ortiz fight this weekend?
Yeah.
17-0, 17 knockouts. It was a tough test. Maurice Hooker's legit. He's game. One of the nicest people in boxing. What did you think?
I mean, Virgil Ortiz was going to win the fight, but I think Maurice could have put it on the line a little bit better. You know what I mean? I mean, okay, I understand he broke his hand, but you know how many fighters fought with broken hands? I mean, you know, I mean, you give, if you're in there, you take that risk. So if you're in there and your hand is broke or whatever, you got to stick it out. You got to be a soldier, man. You know what I mean? And but it was a matter of time anyway. He was going to get stopped.
But Virgil, I'll tell you, I never sparred him. But people who spar him, he fights for 47. They tell me he hits like 68. He's a very, very heavy-handed fighter.
You can see that. I mean, you can see that he's very, because, I mean, every punch he threw was to the body.
So yeah, with intention. It's not, no.
Yes, there's no setting up. He's letting it go.
He's only 22. Can you believe that?
That's good, man.
Big future. Oh, a lot of time. I know Crawford's your favorite fighter. One of them, at least. Him and Crawford, what do you think?
Not right now. I think he needs a few more fights like Hooker to get. You got it when you're fighting guys of that and that nature. You got to get ready for that. You got to fight guys that are going to get you ready for that. You know what I mean? You know, you can face different guys with different styles. Now you just can't be Maurice Hooker and jump from Maurice Hooker to Terrence Crawford. No.
Now you train also Sergey Kovalev.
Yes.
He may fight. I'm not making this up, but he may, because Golden Boy just signed a 175-pounder in Suter Ramirez. What about Suter Ramirez and Kovalev? Do you like the fight?
Of course.
Why?
I think it'll be a great fight. I mean,
Suter's 41-0.
I know. That's why it'll be a great fight. He's a tall southpaw.
Yes,
right?
Correct. Yes. How do you beat him? He looks like a singer. Like, he doesn't look like a boxer. No, a good kid. I like him. Do you know what we're talking about? If you saw his picture, you would never believe he's a boxer.
I'm not a name person.
Okay. But he's 41-0. 41 have tried, 41 have failed, as they say. But
oh, yes. I mean, listen, it's not going to be a walk in the park. You know what I mean? So the key is just to get ready and handle our business.
That's it. And the last thing I wanted to ask you about, so that was Kovalev and Mike Tyson today. And I sent a message to Mike Tyson's people because I want to hear back. But the team of Evander said we offered him $25 million to fight in Miami on Labor Day weekend, and Tyson turned it down. I think there's more to the story.
Of course, without a doubt.
Like, why would you turn down $25 million?
I think there's probably a whole lot more to the story.
So we'll have to find out
exactly
what the story is.
Inquiring minds want to know.
Yeah, let's hear back. Because when you only hear one side, buddy.
There you go.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. Buddy McGregor right here. FaceNewsReporting.com. And Zekbach reporting.